Hello, let's discuss kinds of tests today. A test is a tool that is used to measure something. The something may be conformance with the requirement, conformance with guidelines for good design, identification of design problems, ease of system learning, retention of learning over time, speed of task completion, speed of need fulfillment, error rates, subjective user satisfaction. A test is usually formal, okay? It is created and applied intentionally and with a purpose. It is usually based upon some kind of criteria and understanding of what a good result would be. Several testing techniques at varying levels of sophistication and cost are available to exercise the system. Okay, there are some guidelines here. A review of the interface in terms of an organization standard and design guidelines is the test is. Advantages of testing can be performed by developers. Low cost, can identify general and recurring problems, particularly useful for identifying screen design and layout problems. Disadvantages are mainly severe conceptual, navigation and operational problems. Now the first kind of test is heuristic evaluation, a detailed evaluation of a system by interface design specialist to identify problems. The advantages of heuristic evaluation are easy to do, relatively low cost, doesn't waste users' time, can identify many problems. Disadvantages. Evaluator must possess interface design expertise. Evaluators may not possess an adequate understanding of the task and user communities. Difficult to identify system-wide structural problems. Difficult to uncover missing exits and interface elements. Difficult to identify the most important problems among all problems uncovered. Doesn't provide any systematic way to generate solutions to the problem uncovered. There are some guidelines. Use 3 to 5 expert evaluators. Choose knowledgeable people familiar with the project situation, possessing a long-term relationship with the organization. Description here is, in a heuristic evaluation, interface specialists study a system in depth and look for properties they know. From experience will lead to problems. The interface judge we judge it for its compliance with recognized usability principles, the heuristics. Advantages: a heuristic evaluation is relatively easy to do and its cost is very low. It doesn't waste the user's valuable time. It can also identify many usability problems. Disadvantages are the evaluator should possess user interface expertise. This greatly restricts the population from which evaluators can be are chosen. Because of the small size of this available group, evaluators may not possess an adequate understanding of the system tasks and the user communities. Even expert reviewers have great difficulty knowing how typical users, especially first-time users, will really behave. With this method of evaluation, it is difficult to identify deeper design problems, including system-wide structural problems, missing objects and missing interface elements or features. It is also difficult to identify the most common problems among those documented. Finally, this method doesn't provide any systematic way to generate solution to the problem uncovered. Guidelines. Based upon a study, Nielsen suggests that the optimum expert group size to satisfactorily perform a heuristic evaluation is 3 to 5 people. He found that different evaluators tend to find different problems, and one person will never be able to find the number of usability problems that several people will. Nielsen also found that including more than 5 evaluators doesn't gain enough additional usability information for the extra cost involved. Ideally, evaluators used should be familiar with the project situation and possess a long-term relationship with the developing organization. This suggestion is often difficult to achieve, however. Heuristic evaluation process. Preparing the session. Select evaluators. Prepare or assemble a project review. Overview. A checklist of heuristics. Provide briefing to evaluators to review the purpose of the evaluation session. Preview the evaluation process. Present the project overview and heuristics. Answer any evaluator questions. Provide any special evaluator training that may be necessary. Conducting the session now. Have each evaluator review the system alone. The evaluator should establish own process or method of reviewing the system. Provide usage scenarios if necessary. Compare his or her findings with a list of usability principles. Identify any other relevant problems or issues. Make at least 2 passes through the system Detected problem should be related to the specific heuristics they violate. Comments are recorded either by the evaluator or by observer. The observer may answer questions and provide hints. Restrict the length of the session to no more than 2 hours. Now let's discuss preparing the session in detail. First, I described above. Select 3 to 5 evaluators. Ideally, the evaluators used should be familiar with the project situation and possess a long-term relationship with the developing organization. Then prepare or assemble a project overview and checklist of heuristics. A useful checklist may be available from one or more evaluators. Examples of checklists are found in the tables. We discussed that. Finally, provide a briefing to the evaluators to review the purpose of the evaluation session, to preview the entire evaluation process that is being undertaken, to present the project overview and heuristics, and to answer any questions the evaluator may have. Any special evaluator training that may be necessary can also be provided at this time. This briefing session will normally consume 45 to 60 minutes. Okay, there are some examples at least here. Okay, research based setup heuristics are: automate unwanted workload, free cognitive resources for high level tasks, eliminate mental calculations, estimations, comparisons and unnecessary thinking, reduce uncertainty, display data in a manner that is clear and obvious, fuse data, reduce a cognitive load by bringing together lower level data into higher level summation, presenting information with meaningful aids to interpretation, use a familiar framework, making it easier to absorb, use everyday terms, metaphors and so on. Use names that are conceptually related to functions, context dependent, attempt to improve recall and recognition. Group data in consistently meaningful ways to decrease search time. Limit data driven task. Reduce the time needed to assimilate raw data. Make appropriate use of color and graphics. Include in the displays only that information needed by a user at a given time. Allow users to remain focused on critical data. Exclude extraneous information that is not relevant to current task. Provide multiple coding of data where appropriate. Practice judicious redundancy to resolve the conflict between heuristic 6 and 8. Okay. Now, possible web page heuristics. Okay. Checklist of web pages. Speak the user's language. Use familiar words, phrases and concepts. Present information in a logical and natural order. Be consistent. Indicate similar concepts through identical terminology and graphics. Adhere to uniform conventions for layout, formatting typefaces, labeling and so on. Minimize the user's memory load. Take advantage of recognition rather than recall. Do not force users to remember key information across documents. Build flexible and efficient systems. Accommodate a range of user sophistication and diverse user goals. Provide instructions where useful. Layout screens so that frequently accessed information is easily found. Design aesthetic and minimalist systems. Create visually pleasing displays. Eliminate information that is irrelevant or distracting. Use chunking. Write materials so that documents are short and contain only one topic. Do not force the user to access multiple documents to complete a single thought. Provide progressive levels of details. Organize information hierarchically with more general information appearing before more specific detail. Encourage the user to delve as deeply as needed, but to stop whenever sufficient information has been obtained. Give navigational feedback. Facilitate jumping between related topics. Allow the user to determine his or her current position in the document structure. Make it easy to return to an initial state. Don't lie to user. Eliminate erroneous, misleading links. Do not refer to missing information. Now let's discuss conducting the session. Each evaluator should inspect the system alone, not with or in the presence of other evaluators. This is to ensure independent and unbiased evaluations from each evaluator. Allow the evaluators to establish their own process or method of reviewing the system. Ideally, let the evaluator use the system without procedural assistance. Browsing as is felt necessary. If, however, The evaluators are not familiar with the system's content and purpose. They may be provided with scenarios listing the steps a user would take to perform a sample set of realistic user tasks. During the session, the evaluators will compare their findings with the list of usability principles. Detected problems should be related to the specific heuristic they violate. Multiple heuristics can be linked to any one identified problem. Other relevant problems or issues can also be noted. Two or more passes should be made through the system. Evaluator's comment can be recorded either by the evaluator or by an observer. Evaluator written comments require additional effort by the evaluator during the review process and can break the continuity of the evaluation process. Having an observer record the evaluator's verbal comments adds to the overhead of the session, but reduces the evaluator's workload and allows greater focusing on the review process. If the same observer is used for all evaluation sessions, session results should be available faster since the observer only needs to understand and organize one set of personal notes, not multiple reports or reviews written by all session participants. The observer may answer questions and provide hints to the evaluator as necessary. Evaluators not familiar with the system's content will occasionally need advice. Also, precious time will not be wasted by the evaluator struggling with the interface's mechanics. Observer comments should be restricted to situations where the evaluator is clearly confused or in trouble. Finally, to minimize evaluator fatigue, restrict the length of a session to about 2 hours. For large or complicated interfaces that require more time to evaluate, it is better to split the session into several sessions, each concentrating on a part of the interface. After the session, when all evaluator and observer's notes have been compiled, hold a debriefing session, no more than 2 hours in length. Include all the observers and design team members. Have each evaluator present the problems detected and heuristic each violated. Assemble a composite list of usability problems if one has not yet been compiled. Solicit and discuss design suggestions for improving the problematic aspects of the system. After debriefing the session from the composite list of violations into ratings form, request the evaluator to assign severity ratings to each violation on a scale ranging from usability catastrophe to not a usability problem mentioned in the table below. We discussed that. It is difficult to obtain these estimates during the evaluation process, where the focus is on finding problems, then analyze the results and establish a program to correct the necessary violations and deficiencies. The ratings will identify the most serious problems, the first in need of attention. This is the table. Zero means what? I don't agree that this is a usability problem at all. One means cosmetic problem only, need not be fixed unless extra time is available. A minor usability problem fixing should be given a low priority. A major usability problem important to fix and should be given a high priority. A usability catastrophe will imperative to fix before the product can be released. Thank you. Thank you for watching.